Mic check, 1, 2, 1, 2. About to go live soon. Less than a minute, less than 30 seconds. Can I get a check in chat? Mic check, audio check. Let me know if you can hear me. Please, as I powder my nose before we go live. Showtime. Welcome. Tuesday, May 17th. Check in the chat, scroll, and welcome to another stream of Roller Coaster Tycoon World. For those that are new to the stream, my name is Adam, aka Nook Riot. Nook Riot, Nook, whatever you want to call me. Here to share some info with you, some news today. Scroll in the chat. You guys have been chattering amongst yourselves for quite some time now, which I always love to see. DaVinci, or is it Dave Inc. Style Games? I'm going to call you DaVinci from now on. That's the first thing I see when I scroll past that name really fast. We're going to be sharing patch updates with you today. What's coming? First and foremost, for those unaware, if you have not followed us, follow us here on Twitch, on Twitter, on Facebook. We're over on Steam. We got our forums as well. I should probably make a note to get all of those links to spam the chat with as I take notes over here on the left-hand side. Way over here. If my mods don't already have them, which they may. I see Grandmaster NYC out there. DJ Bass, yeah, just call me Nook. That's fine. Love it. Panda Productions, your birthday comes in a few days. Well, I'm excited for your birthday. Happy birthday if I miss it. I'm just scrolling again through chat here, making sure I am not missing anything before we kick off our lovely update that we have in store for you today. Ladies and gentlemen, boys, uh-oh! Can you guys see that? Added some follow for notifications, followers. Cam Chow, thanks for the follow. Got too loud? I can always turn that down. Let me know if that follower notification is too loud. Yes, busy with the optimize. Yes, the dev team is hard at work optimizing, yes. Online Lars, hi Mr. Rollercoaster Tycoon, hello Online Lars, excuse me, as I get my speaking chops here, hopefully I can speak today as well as type. Yeah, that was too loud, alright, cool, thanks for that update, I'm gonna go turn that down real, oh, there's another one, oh, it's gonna go deaf, don't go deaf on me, please. Brand new, I'm actually gonna crank it all the way down to about that. Oh, here it comes, mute your ears. Alright, so the next one that comes through, settings have been saved, that should be, oh, JSTOR, that's a little bit better now, hopefully. Maybe Total, welcome Total, how you doing? 9,000 nods, lower a little bit, JSTOR following, welcome. Thank you for following. Alright, we got another one here, Lara Croft Online following, thank you for the follows today, everyone loving it. If it's too loud, let me know. I did lower it. It's sitting at about 10% right now. And I may have to clip the actual notification sound, too, because it may be a little bit too long. It's, I think, about 15 seconds right now. Tony, thanks for the follow. Foxy Boy, BT27. Hey, everybody following, flowing in now. Okay. Peter, Steph, 9000, DSNY, Bert. Appreciate all those follows, you guys. Game music is too high. Blister, alright, I'll turn down the game music. It's not the game music, though. It's the notification sound, the follow. Let me go. It's sitting at about 10% right now, so I'm going to put it down to 5. We'll go ahead and save that one. There we go. I think that's a little bit better now. Nice and low. Coming in really loud and hot in my headset. I'm going to lower that just a little bit. So, not only are we trying to make the game better, I'm trying to make the stream a little bit better for you guys. Add quality to it. Much better. Sylvester, thank you. Grandmaster, thank you. Perfect. Looks good. We wished it was the game music. It's not the game music. It's the notification sound. I appreciate your patience while I update that and get that nice and mellow for you guys. Really do appreciate all those follow here. The real Chris Sawyer has followed. The real Chris, welcome. Thank you for the follow. Love it. So this thing is rolling like crazy. And it's a little bit backed up now because I had a bunch of follows less than a couple of minutes ago. So we'll let that flow through every single time. There's 9,000. So there's about three left after 9,000 goes through. That's wonderful. Yeah, but I want to have the pop up there too as well. Get as many people as we can on the follow. Joel, Bernie. Hey, Bernie. You weren't Bernie. You just started following? What happened? You're always here. What happened? Colm Bice back in 40 minutes. Thank you. See you then. Yes, we do have updates today. Enough with the distraction of the notification sound. Again, if I turned down, so it should be all right. Hopefully it's not too loud. Again, you're sick of watching it. Well, I'm not going to tell people to stop following, so I may just turn it off. So it's only got a couple more to catch up, and then it should be all right. Skip it. Did they come through? Yes, Blister, love your park, by the way. Awesome park. There's a couple of others, too. We're going to be having our featured user of the week. Hopefully tomorrow we'll have everything wrapped up and get that posted out for you. Stitch Scout, thank you. I'm going to skip these. You see Bernie Moon, I gave you guys a shout already because he had so many in a row. It's kind of backed up there. That's what happens. Way better. Good. Like I said, we're going to be looking at our featured user on Wednesday. There's a couple lined up that want to show us their stuff, so we're going to take the opportunity to do just that and show. I'm going to keep killing those as they come in, so hopefully that'll be a little bit better. The video is nice. Steph, thanks. I appreciate that. Steph Wondergem, love it. Welcome. You seem like a new face in chat. Welcome. DJ, you weren't following. What happened? You're here every stream, and you just followed us now. All right, so we're going to keep popping that skip. So first and foremost, looking at the notes that I do have in front of me, and hopefully you guys can hear me, hear the rustling of the papers, the patch note goodness in front of me. First and foremost, new content that is up and coming. And for those of you that have not seen a development stream yet, what I like to do is I like to go down, notes in my hand, I'll run down them, I'll talk through them, and then jump into a park to show some of the updates to you guys, so that you know that this is coming down the pipe, this is what you're going to get in the next update. I'm going to keep skipping those alerts as they come through. Yeah, I know, just follow, all the longtime lurkers just following. Loving the follows, by the way, guys, keep them coming. So, like again, to recap, for those that are just joining, I'm going to run through the actual patch notes and then all the talking points of what's going to be coming, and then I'm going to jump into a park. I'm probably going to use the park that we worked on last week in Sandbox and Chill just to go over, not to have a big, huge super park or start from scratch, something right in the middle. This way we can look and see some of the cool new stuff that's there. First up, new features and content. We have a new sci-fi centerpiece. This goes hand in hand with some of the other graphics updates that I'll talk about here later on a little bit. But yeah, it's basically a new centerpiece. It's like a giant moon rock, and I will actually pick it out. Hopefully it will work properly with me, and we'll get to see it. It's kind of like a big giant rune mock. Can I get a rune mock in chat, please? Moon rock floating through space, and you can actually, if you're good enough, you can place coasters through it. Right on down the list, talking about some other graphical improvements and enhancements. I apologize, I have multiple modes of communication going on here. Sorry, you're going to see my head bobbing all around the place today. Very busy week here for us. Oh, look at these follows, going and going and going. Yes, follow, keep going. So fresh, loving it. Some of the other graphical updates. Yeah, I'm getting too many coming through here, so I'm just going to kill it. Too busy. I have too much going on. There's another one. Oh, there goes another one. You can hear the sounds. Notification sound. Disabled. Alright, let's see. Sorry, back all over the place. Let's save those settings. Hopefully you guys will not hear any more of those notifications. They're nice in theory, but when you get a whole ton that just came through, all you lurkers out there that have not been following, I see you. Back to the updates. Keeping my ear out for those notifications coming through. Terrain shaders, a little bit better to improve the terrain quality. We'll probably check some of those out when we get into the actual game. You will see terrain shaders in the forest and other maps. Different texture blends help them. Some of you, if you've played the game a lot, you notice that the textures have some patterns to them. The blending helps make them look a little more smoother, more natural when zooming in and out, so that's going to be lovely. Space reflections, which I had mentioned in the last stream when we were talking about the updates coming through. This is kind of like an iteration that they were working on. They had rolled out space reflections to a couple of different things, and that should now be across all objects in the game. What this does, greatly improves the look and feel of all the objects in the game. While not everything is a mirror, everything has a reflection, has a surface. It will reflect something to some degree, so you should be able to see those a little bit better. Make things look definitely much cooler, much more reflective, responsive to the environment. Here's another one. Depth of field added to the park cam. This is one of those, how do I say it? Optimizations? They are working on tweaking camera to help with performance. So one of the things that they've done is they've added a depth of field. And that's, I'm sitting here on the main menu because it's actually an option that you can mess with when you're playing with it, when you get this build. So I'm going to show you that as we jump off right here. I know you guys don't like to hear me just yammer on and on and on, so I'm going to try and keep it as brief as possible to get in and show you. Some of the other improvements in terms of graphics quality, sci-fi coaster loading stations, they have new textures. Depth of field we already talked about. Same thing with some of the cams as well. One of the other ones I want to talk to here now is paths, because you know we all know and love the pathing system so much. That has gotten an update. And as I go over here to the side, multiple chat communications and modes of text going on here back and forth. The path systems have gotten an update. So as with all the other pieces in the actual game itself, what we're trying to do is do it in pieces. So we want to be able to, and I'm getting load the music. All right, cool. So before I carry on, I'm going to quick options audio. I'm going to bring this way down. And then just to make sure that I'm doubled up, let's go over here on the left-hand side, about 75%. So wait for that to kick in and let me know if that's still too loud. If it is, again, I will update it. Yes. Major B. Welcome. I didn't see you. I'm not paying attention to chat. I'll scroll through chat here momentarily, just another few minutes. It's almost already 15 after, and I'm still going through patch notes. Lovely patch notes. So, pants. There's been some updates. They are being worked on, and everybody knows that this is quite challenging sometimes to work with the pants. So, what they're doing is with all the other pieces in the game itself, they're working through an iterative fashion. So, they're going to roll out updates. Not all at once, but more in a step-by-step fashion. Baby steps. You'll hear me say that throughout every dev stream we do. Baby steps, right? You don't want to roll out something so large that something else is compromised, right? So you want to do it in baby steps. Run it through QA, which I'm hoping they're going to be putting it through tomorrow. You guys are looking to get this update sometime this week. Still unconfirmed on when it's coming. Soon. And I'm going to get a zoom effect to do that because I think that would be awesome. And all of the theme park simulation Facebook boys and girls out there will probably love to get a couple of screen grabs, maybe make some more memes. Love those. So, and I'm going to walk through, it's kind of hard to explain. What they've done is they've gone through and updated the node system for paths. What used to happen was you would go through and create all of your paths and it would make nodes. And when you would go delete them, it would leave the old nodes in place on the map. So what they've done is they've gone through and made it clean itself up. So when you go to delete nodes or delete the paths, it'll go ahead and clean up those nodes on the back end after the fact, which makes it much more responsive. And you'll see that too. You'll be able to get much closer. You'll be able to connect paths better. Still, again, not perfect because we're not there yet. But I think it's going to be much more playable for you guys. You guys are going to enjoy that much more. Just keep going down the line here. I think I'm at a good segue point here to break to just scroll the chat a little bit because I love to interact with you guys. You know that. Want to make sure I got questions that I'm not missing or shout-outs that I'm not missing. I think Grandmaster is handling business as he normally does. Shout-out to Grandmaster NYC 2016 for his fabulous moderating skills. Yeah, seeing the game. How's that game music now, guys? I see a bunch of chat scroll that I missed about the music being too loud. I think we're good. I think we're okay. Grandmaster handling business. Love to see it. Nice. Give Roller Coaster Tycoon some love. Nothing but love. There's some more music is loud. Hopefully you guys can hear me. I'll scoot up just a little bit to the mic so it's you can hear that golden radio voice. Music down, music down. Yeah, I'm sorry, guys. I missed all of those. All right, so I think it's good now. And I can mute it. I don't know. Only one person wanted to mute it. Oh, there's enough. Just mute the alert. Yeah, we muted the alerts. The alerts are gone. People look like they've stopped following, too, for now. So, looking good, looking good. Getting down to the end now here. I see a couple of Planet Coaster shout-outs. Nothing but love for the team over at Planet Coaster. Major asking, have the queue paths been done so we can curve them yet? Not yet, Major. That is definitely on the list. A lot of people were asking about specific paths and curving, specifically queues and curving. Pardon me. Tycoonieth! I see you lurking around in there. You will find. Who are you finding? You're not finding me. I'm right here. You don't need to look for me. I'm right here. Looking good. Boxy boy, when will we get Dark Ride? All right, there's another request for Stop the Music. I'm going in, audio, main is down. We're done. So now all you can hear is me. Too loud, music is completely done. You guys won't hear anything. And when we bring it back in, I'm going to adjust the manual side here at about 50%, half. Good. Now, yes, Adam is my name. That is correct. So I think we handled most of the chat questions except for the dark rides. When piece by piece is done and dusted, that should give us dark rides. Looking good, looking good. All right, cool. Nothing. All right, that's the end of the chat. Grandmaster's handling other questions as they come through, so to continue on, so it's not just a stream of me scrolling chat and asking questions, we can actually see some of the stuff. We went through some of the graphic improvements. I can speak today. I had a terrible time speaking. Keep getting caught on my tongue. So one of the things that we've mentioned in every dev stream so far, and even outside of dev stream, is AI. Peep AI. There's a bunch of different things that are going on in terms of Peep AI. I mean, it's a lot to consume right now in terms of updates and fixes and patches and stuff like that. But they keep making passes. Every new patch that comes out, there's more AI updates and fixes. So for this one specifically, foods, drinks, and souvenirs. Peeps now have a higher chance to address their nausea, bathroom hunger, or thirst when these stats are high. They should also no longer buy drinks hoping to soothe their hunger and vice versa. So a little bit of balancing and tweaking on the AI side so they'll actually satisfy their needs a little bit better. Instead of giving a higher priority to other things as needed, and the randomization between a bunch of different things in terms of top five food or drink or souvenir stands, again, it comes down to balance and priority. And we'll see that when you go through and you play it, they'll feel a little bit smarter. They're like they're actually going to where they need to be going as well. And that also affects things like their overall stats. So as a consequence of these balancing pieces here in terms of the patch that's coming out, they're going to be generally happier when buying food and drinks. I know there's, for specific example, if you have one souvenir shop in your entire park and peeps go buy something, they say they want to buy something, they go buy, and sometimes they'll get angry because that's all there is. Well, that's been balanced and adjusted a little bit, so you should be able to see a little bit better thoughts and skill updates in terms of their stats. Skill updates, they're not leveling up. Next, injured peeps will engage in their appropriate behavior, sitting on the benches to be addressed by medics or leaving the park. One of the other things, too, is they should ride rides less, but I don't think that's 100% confirmed right now. I think that one's still got to go through. Nausea in bathrooms. This is always a great one because everybody knows how much pee is all over our path systems whenever we have it. So now this is balanced. They're going to rely more on choosing a nearby bathroom if they either need to vomit or use the bathroom. One of the thoughts now is they should have the paths here are disgusting bubble the appropriate amount in their thought section of their stats. Peeps with moderately high nausea will now prefer to sit on benches to reduce it. So in addition to going to the bathroom to quote-unquote get it all out, sit on a bench, take a chill, take deep breaths and relax, the nausea pass. Some of the other peeps' nausea tolerance will be increased if they like riding more intense rides. So it's like a kind of like a balance thing. Their tolerance is going to go up if they do like to ride more intense rides. Moving on down the line, in terms of rides, there was an issue that was preventing rides from increasing riders' energy and decreasing riders' boredom. That should now be fixed. And it's kind of like, layout is a little bit different on these patch notes here that I received, so you're kind of jumping around a little bit. And we're already pushing 321. I'm going to make sure we keep it on track here. Yes, peeps should now more reliably ride, alliteration, killing me with these patch notes here. Low intensity rides, peeps will now ride them more reliably. Excuse me, take a sip of my tea over here, I'm getting a little parched. That's what happens when you talk too much. Hydration, it's all about hydration. As a consequence to the intensity balancing, peeps should now distribute themselves among the park attractions more evenly so they won't be bunched up at one specific ride. And you'll see that a little bit better, too. The park we're going to use is the one from last week, so there's not a whole lot of peeps in there that we may be able to look at, but we still will look at some. Improved emotes and peep thoughts to be more descriptive and trigger more often. That's one of the first things. Well, that's actually the second thing I noticed when I started playing the latest build. Improved transition of janitor animation from cleaning and walking. So some people have noticed it was kind of choppy from them moving from when they're actually cleaning something to actually walking. That has been updated, so that's a great one. Peeps now have an ill or a sick animation when their nausea, bathroom, thirst, or hunger get too high for too long. So what you saw in the previous build was they kind of like holding their arms, kind of like that injured animation. Well, that was used for a couple of other things as well. There's an additional ill or sick animation added to that one too. So one of the other big things here too that you will see, I want to make sure that I didn't miss anything here. There's one piece that we'll get to in just a minute. Audio that I'm saving for the very end. Nothing too crazy on audio, but screen space reflections. Now disabled when zoomed out for performance. So again, in this early alpha build, they're trying to tweak different things to help with performance and optimization. Where are you at, chat? Optimization. Pound, optimize. Make it a hashtag. Love it. Let's make it go viral. So that's going to be good. Performance thing as well. UGC Content Manager. This is a big overhaul, and this is a visual one to show you. We're going to get in there and talk about it here in just a minute. The actual UI has been updated. So you had the big, kind of like a big thumbnail, and it was a description, and then the ability to rate all over. They kind of squished it down a little bit, made them a little bit more user-friendly and easier to manage when you're going through and looking and cycling through the menus. UI and UX general notification improvements to better inform players of what's going on in their park. Terrain brush sizes were also tweaked as well. Improved cameras while in coaster editing tool. And then as we kind of scroll on down here, looking on audio. So a lot of audio changes are coming. People are talking about adding their own music and stuff like that. That's not here yet. What they're doing is they're making a bunch of different passes in terms of how the audio works now. Little things like different ambient noises, more ambient noises based on the map, based on the ride, based on the day-night cycle. So there's a bunch of different things that are going on there. Nothing too crazy. One of the other big ones here, too, this is almost towards the end of the list now, as we're pushing on a half an hour, so I can get in there and show you some stuff, too. And I will scroll chat. I see you out of the corner of my eye scrolling. I will talk to you momentarily. The last piece that we want to talk about here, there's actually two minor pieces here, is the paths. A big alpha feature in paths right now is to recolor the paths after you place them. And we'll go through showing some of that. It's kind of segmented right now. Again, it's just a first pass. It's going to be updated and be a little bit better. Well, I think that's going to do it. We're going to do one more chat scroll here before we get into. I got my trusty notebook. I'll be taking notes, as I always do. I saw lots of scrolling going on here. Yeah, Thiessen, I know. A couple other people are agreeing with you to have. I think I'm going to adjust that. I would like to sit and talk through the patch notes. I know that's a little boring. Or I should say it's very boring. So next time I'm going to do that. I'm going to show them anyway here. We got about a half an hour left, a little over half an hour. And there's another one. There's another one. Yep. Looking good. Without the music, yeah, Death Tone, thank you. I'm going to do that when I come. When I kick it into the beginning, I'll keep that muted. Notifications will also be muted as well. Trying to make the stream a little more jazzy, if you will. Good, good, good. I think we got to see no more shout-outs. You guys are talking amongst yourselves, which is great. Love it. Good, 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 good. So now, on to what we're talking about here. First and foremost, in options. We talked about this specific depth of field. This is a new option that you guys can see when you get this build. What they're doing is they're creating this depth of field to help with performance. And I'm keeping it on medium right now, so when I launch the game, you'll be able to see it. What happens is it kind of creates a blur effect of things that are beyond a certain level of distance. So when you go into the game and you want to change these, you can leave it completely disabled, you medium or high, whichever you choose. But by default, right now, it's set to medium, and that's what it will run at. So the first thing you do when you get the new build, you want to come in and check that out and mess with it. I know the couple of times I have launched it over when I first started up medium, it was a little, it's different. You're going to see it, and I'm going to keep it like that. This way we can see it. I'm actually going to make sure all my other stuff is turned up here, level of detail. Looking good. I definitely want to sync, please. Thank you. Please, yes, please, and thank you. Enable what I can, looking good. And then I'm going to jump into the content manager. Give this a minute to load. So yeah, you'll see that it kind of drops off the bottom a little bit. But now you can see, I'm actually going to go to my community so we can see all of the beautiful things. So immediately, there, it's not long rows of the little thumbnail and then the description and the rating system and all this other stuff. Now they're like in this little thumb mode to where you can go in and click and bring it up. And they kind of took everything that was at that higher level of the UI and put it in the pop-up when you disable and hide. You can rate it here and you can see the date and all the, you know, how long that person has been online or the last time they were seen online and all that good stuff. And that makes it much more user-friendly. And I already made the note that it kind of like drops off my screen here down at the bottom, but that's okay. But again, the paging, you can go through, you can see, you can select 10, this is, and it'll update automatically, 10, 25, or 50, and then you can go all of your different pages and check out what's what. That's really cool. I know a lot of people are asking about, you know, smoothing the UI and making it a little bit more user-friendly to be able to see certain things. And again, it's just a first pass right now or second pass or whatever. But the key being they're going to do multiple passes of that to make sure that they streamline it and it is more user-friendly. So keeping my patch notes handy on the side, this way I have my talking points to run through. I'm actually going to load up the one we use, Nook Lake, there it is. So I'm going to go ahead and load this one up. This way it's not a completely blank sandbox, and it's not a completely fleshed out park. As we patiently wait for the loading times. Yes, gameplay coming. Dave Inc., it's coming. Loading. Master Hellish, no confirmation on this patch yet as of a date this week. They're going to be passing it to QA to get it locked down, to get it out to you guys. And as soon as it goes live, you will see your Steam update. Okay, so this, that's funny. It's actually the coaster that we used as it loads. What am I sitting at? Oh, wow, sitting at 600 or so. I'm going to put it on pause. You can see all the peeps still loaded up from last time. There's a ton of garbage and pee all over. So I'm going to keep it on pause as I build through because it does help with placing things. This way they're not getting in the way. And then you'll be able to see some of the animations as well. So one of the first things we wanted to talk about was paths. Again, noting that it's not perfect, but the updates that they brought through. New UI updates. First thing you guys are going to notice is small, medium, and large is gone. What they've added over here on the left side is a slider. And you can kind of see, let me zoom that out a little bit. And because it's kind of behind the UI, it's tough to see a little bit, but you can slide now instead of picking the tabs on the UI, small, medium, large, you slide it and see it up and down. This little button over here, straight, what that is going to become now as they pass it over and finalize the build is it's going to be straight and curved. So down here, the curved, it's basically so when you're selecting regular path and queues, you're talking about that straight and curved, the curved queue, right? Well, this is the jump off stage for them to do further development on the pathing system as well. Again, by no means perfect, better than what we did have, and we're going to keep on making changes. So the modify tab, you won't see, you'll notice that the actual modifier on the right and then the actual scaling bar on the left went away, but what this piece does, it allows you to change the path texture after the path has already been placed. So I'm going to do that here in just a minute, so we'll go back to create as we focus on paths, get nice and smooth. So we'll just do regular cobblestone. So now you notice here, you can see how it jumps and snaps to that node, right? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create, I'm just going to make some snapping right here so it's nice and straight. Nice small path. What you can do now is you can get it to where it's easier. Remember how we used to just jump all over the place like crazy? Now it's more smooth because it's trying to look at the nodes a little bit differently. So you'll be able to get in there and create and be more precise with your paths. And now because you see how that red, again, not perfect, but because it's interacting with that other node before it, that's one of the issues that they're trying to work on as well. So you make your curved paths as you would, but then come back into straight paths and trying to, all right, let's go ahead and click at an intersection here. Let's go ahead and click here. See how it's still jumping and trying to be smart about it? So again, you turn off your snapping and try to freewheel it. It won't jump until you get super close. But again, because it's one node here and one node here, it's not letting you. Again, not perfect, but still being able to connect things in a fashion that are a little bit easier. Still, again, not perfect, but being able to go through now, because I've created so many different, I switched over to freeform mode there. But now you can see a bunch of different sections that I've made over here with the curved and the straight paths as well. So one of the other bits is modified on the two different tabs now. You'll be able to go in and select, and it's very faint right now, and I'm pretty sure that they have every intention to make it a little bit more, I guess you could say visible, for lack of a better term, to which actual piece you're selected. Like, so if you see how it's selected all these different ones, boom, you can change them on the fly. And now what it's doing right now, again, this is a first pass. You're going to hear that a lot out of my mouth today. It's picking the segment that it's updating with the texture. So if you have one long path, right now you can't go and select a piece of it to make a different texture. But if you were to make it in segments all the way through, it would allow you to do that. So again, coming down here onto here on this side or this side, pull this off and get some shadows up in there too. Pull the cycle back on. See how this works. There we go. Some moon shadows. And there's daytime. I'm going to freeze it on daytime so the shadows will come back up too. This way you can see. So that's another piece I want to get to is the space reflections. You'll be able to see those a little bit better. Back to modification. So it's really tough to see like which ones you have selected. And it may not even be letting me right now. So we go back to create again, alpha mode, early access. There we go. Sometimes you notice that if you've played the early access build, just switching back and forth between UI helps to clear some things up. So let's make this one the round interlocking. And again, because of the way the intersections work on top of the sections, it's trying to be smart about selecting the intersection itself as being the most used because there are so many different connections to that node on the path. So it's going to use that as the general starting point, and then the one that's longest or the most connected to that actual intersection point, it's going to make the different. Look at this peepee's just hanging out, just wandering, munching on something. The new, see that new animation? Oh, is that a new animation we saw? I don't know. He was eating something. So again, looking here, changing this individual one. See how it's going to the actual intersections, the most used intersections. Well aware of this. Again, it's a first pass. Keeping things in mind, like updates coming, you know, further patches. It's going to be easier to use. I think I've definitely had an easier time using it as I've gone through with this build. So definitely looking good in terms of that one. There was another path piece here. The nodes were good. So you'd be able to go through. Now, in terms of deletion, let's just go through. Again, you know, noted being able to delete multiple things. Let's go ahead and just clear this out. There shouldn't be any issues. Oh, there it goes. I say that shouldn't be any issues, and then watch. As soon as I get in there, see, and it's going, and it doesn't leave because it's clearing that old node. That old node is gone. That path just went back to its original texture. So those little things, little... I don't see any shout-outs. I do want to scroll chat just a quick minute here, making sure I'm not missing anybody. Nice progress on the path. Thank you, Master. Mirnok looks better. One of the reasons I haven't booted up the gear for a while is the pathing and performance. So good start. Cool. Yeah, there's definitely some updates. I mentioned a bunch of different performance things to help as well. Mir asking about you slide but keep three increments. Yes, currently right now it's just those increments of small, medium, large are technically still there. The dynamic sizing is not ready yet. So looking good. I don't want to scroll back too far. I think that's about as far as I go. Yeah, content manager sitting on the bottom left feels a little weird. Yeah, a couple of other people have mentioned that, Deadly. Looking good. Thank you, Master Hellish. Give me a thank you. Master Hellish, you're most welcome. I think that's good. I think backed up to the other ones. Grandmaster NYC is handling nicely. Again, Grandmaster, thank you. Appreciate that. So back to path building again real quick. You'll notice that it's not trying to snap to any of the nodes that I had previously built there because they're all clean. And that's going to make things a lot more smooth when you're building. So you can see I'm trying to get out of the sections. Slide it all the way over. And you see it's still trying to snap to that one, but it's going to make things a lot more smooth. And again, they're going to come with more updates as well on those. So now I think that's going to cover it for pathing. We talked about the pathing itself and how it works. We talked about the new UI and the sizing. So I think that looks good for right now. We mentioned a bit about the actual space reflections. So you'll see some of those as we're flying through here. Oh, and there are all the emotes. You see a ton. Look at all these people are starving because they've been standing in line forever. So escape out so we don't have that. Time. Yes, Mariela, we want scenery. Yes, there is actually a new scenery piece that I'm going to show here. Centerpiece, sci-fi centerpiece. So let's go in there and find that. Let's dig through the centerpieces. See what this GMO looks like for you guys. Look at that. Asteroid belt. This thing is going to be a monster. You guys ready? Wait for it. Oh my goodness. Oh, this thing is huge. Look at that. And again, this is, I cannot wait to see. So far, we've had a couple of different items that you can build coasters through. The big tree, the mine shaft, this one as well now too. I'm very curious to see sci-fi themes. Wink, wink. I want to see what you guys build. In terms, look at that. That's pretty cool looking, huh? Let's get a freeform camera. Let's take a look at some of this. Oh, wait for it. Oh, oh. Reform camera, taking some other notes here as I see questions coming in, not only in chat, but some PMs as well. Pardon for the silence. Cool. So, JSTOR, when will the shadow motion improve? That's a very good question.
I do not have the answer to that. But as you can see, I'm scribing diligently. Again, pausing. See, there it goes. So the night transition shadows, those went by pretty fast. The daytime ones, again, back to what I'm focused. Focus. You guys are getting me off track. I will look at chat momentarily. Scenery. The moon rock, as they were calling it, the asteroid belt. Awesome piece of scenery for you guys to use. Sci-fi, one of my favorite themes of all time. So please, use it. I want to see multiple asteroid belts with coasters flying through. One of the other graphics pieces we talked about was terrain shaders. So if we come over here and look at all the terrain, you can see the different textures. You remember they were a little less vivid, so to speak. There aren't any other ones in there yet. We get your grass textures, A, B, C, and then sand. And then the other update for this one, too, is the actual the brush multiplier as well. Instead of just, you can see it'll zoom out. As it, and it will resize as you zoom in and out, as it used to do. But now you can take and update the actual multiplier size with the scroller on the right-hand side, which will make it a little bit better. Now we're just going to throw on some sand textures over here. Look at how bright that is. Come down. Very bright. Get really finite down here. You zoom all the way in. More grass textures over here. Select those. So less patterning. You see more detail. I'm going to mix it up a little bit more. A little bit of brown grass. Dying brown grass. That's fine. Some more. Just to show you a little bit how the textures are more detailed now. That's what was one of the optimization pieces that they were talking about. Being able to go through, make things look a little bit more smooth. But definitely still more work to come on this one, so stay tuned on those. More sci-fi. Kev, taking a note. I know they have more to come, but I'm making the shout-out. Kev, sci-fi scenery. Trees. I love the sci-fi trees. They're awesome. The big purple and blue monsters. Those are great. Let's see how everybody's doing down here. That's one of the great things. So, as you can see, one of the AI updates. Oh, look at those updates. They're happier now that they're actually getting off the ride, enjoying it a little bit better. I want to come over to my janitors. Where are my janitors? Right here. Let's go and pull this all the way up. And I'm actually going to build another CAD system here. So let's go through. I think this one is the asphalt one. So let's go ahead and just create another line all the way over. So I want to drop another janitor booth over here just to make it a little bit more powerful to help clean up that park. I'm going to go through and place a couple more trash cans. That's the word I was looking for. Yeah, that's wonderful. And just a small one. I don't want to put a large one yet. And open it, put it up to another 3. That's beautiful. This way it'll help. And you'll see as they go through, I don't want to speed it up. They'll go through and they'll clean up as they're supposed to. Here comes one. You see some of their cleanup animations. Oh, there you go. That was a quick animation. But instead of just that hard block of stopping, there's more slowly increasing the animations, making them a little bit better. Next up on the list, as I pull it over again, talked about the screen flace. I'm struggling to talk today. Screen space reflections we spoke about. That was a great one. The depth of field, that is really one that is, you can kind of see it. If you look at the coaster, so focus with me, chat, if you can. Specifically looking beyond the bathrooms, you can see it starts here very little, being that it's on medium. It's kind of blurry a little bit, and then the coaster in the back is very blurry, and then even the mountains beyond that is even more blurry. That's that depth of field setting. You can turn that off, but again, as a default, when you first log in and you start the game up with the settings, it's going to be on medium. Oh, here comes nighttime again. So you can see that. You zoom in, and the further you look out, you can see how blurry it is. Even that emote, that peep emote, see them? There you go. That's a really good example to use that peep emote right there. And then as you zoom in and you get closer to them, they become more clear. That helps. That helps in terms of performance and optimization. Again, not perfect by any means. More to come, more to work on. So one of the other issues that people have been mentioning, we talked about the AI improvements. Not really a whole lot to do other than let the peeps run amok in the park. I'm going to scroll. I see chat. I see you scrolling, chat. I'm just going through, making sure I'm covering everything. We're pushing on 3:45 here, and I want to make sure I cover the update. And again, this after the fact, when the patch is live, we're going to be updating over on our website, on Steam, on Facebook. It's going to have the full detail of the actual dev blog that comes out, which is inclusive of all the patch notes. So you guys will be able to sit back and grab a cup of tea or coffee. Speaking of tea, I'm actually going to take another sip here. So excuse me just a moment. I'm going to dip kind of out of camera. Ah, much better. Pick you up and move you over here. Just because I can. Just because I feel like it. So one of the things you want to look at, you know, we mentioned that we didn't spend a whole lot of time on was the actual peep thought bubbles. Here, again, pinning from last one. You see it'll float and then you can pin it to wherever you want. See, it's grouping a little bit better, which is awesome because then you can see in groups where what they're doing, what they're thinking about. I should be able to see them over here as well. Sort them by the name, or you can sort them by the thought. This way you can see 135 people say I'm exhausted. Why are they exhausted? I probably have one bench in this entire park. So if I were to go put some benches, that would probably help with some of their exhaustion. People are tired, same thing, starving, hungry. Hopefully they're going to go through. A lot of the people are on these gigantic queue lines, and I can guarantee most of them are starving that are sitting on this line. If they were out and about wandering around, they would be fulfilling their needs much better. But because they're stuck in queue, they can't leave to go get something to eat or drink. So we'll keep on going down the line. Again, running up here on about 10 minutes to the hour. We talked about AI, the nausea in the bathroom, and their tolerance as well. Those are hard to show right now just in terms of sheer time. You guys are going to see that stuff. And again, you see something that's not correct or you have feedback that you want to give, please go over to our forums. You have the early access bug tracker and the early access improvement tracker. Devs look at those every day. They scrape everything off and they put it into a nice big pile for themselves to look at and fix and work through. So please, if you don't log your stuff there, it's hard for it to get seen in multiple places at once. But what do I got? Okay, notifications here on the left side and on the right side. Nice question. I see the Belgium Hunter right away. Well, add vending machines for the queue lines then. Nice. That's actually a pretty novel idea. I like that a lot. This way they can get a snack or a drink while they're waiting, because you know how I like to make queue lines. Queue lines for days, right, chat? Yes. Tom H. asking more Western theme scenery would be cool, and weather system like rain, snow, thunder, hurricanes. A lot of other people have mentioned the weather system. Not anytime soon, but it has been noted. And the themes and scenery stuff, they're coming out in batches. So they were, you know, that scenery piece for sci-fi came out because they were working overall scenery stuff in terms of, you know, texturing and overall graphical improvements for the sci-fi themed items. And that one was in there, so that came out with all those fixes. Kind of like, you know, they have them in segments and sections when they're working on them as well. I'm just, again, scrolling through. I think I might do one set of peep bowling at the end. Perhaps. I have not confirmed yet. I want to make sure I'm not missing anything. So I'll probably get knocked upside my head if I do miss anything, but that's lovely. Yep, again, AI. I'm talking about AI. Yep. Now, another one, too, briefly, maybe did not mention, but peeps should now properly throw their trash out in trash cans. I don't think I have a single trash can in here right now. That's why there's so much garbage all over the place. And it looks like it may have cleaned up a little bit here, so I'm actually going to speed it up to get another day cycle in here. There we go. I'm just going to put it on pause real quick. trash. So basically, peeps were, I don't want to say they were ignoring trash cans. However, I don't think they were using them to their fullest potential. But immediately you can see, I came over here before I went and I put another janitor stall in and increased, so I have a total of six now. It was covered with litter and pee. So now the janitors, their AI is continually getting updated to make sure they're working effectively and wandering through the park and cleaning up. So not only were their animations look a little bit better and more to come, they're going to clean up much better. So you can immediately scroll through. Yeah, there's still some trash over here. But I think, look, I have, if you notice, click fly through, I have no trash cans whatsoever. See that? None. Not one. Why didn't anybody tell me last week I had no trash cans? You're slipping, chat. You guys are slipping. So again, going through, I'm probably going to add more trash cans over here as well. I don't want to tie it up. I want to do make sure I'm not missing anything. Talked about all those. We showed that. We talked about the terrain brush size, the UGC content manager. So I think that's going to cover a large majority of it. One of the other is, like I said, audio. They're making some audio updates. Not being able to add your own custom music as of yet, but there are some other tweaks. I said, like, you may, there's probably going to be soon things like more ambient noises and other musical and audio adjustments as well. So now that I've been neglecting chat for the most time, JSTOR here, I'm just going to start from the bottom up. Yeah, Major B saying, my pants get messy because the janitors weren't emptying the bins properly. Yes, that's another good point. Bins now have a capacity. So when they get to a capacity, the janitors will come empty them, and then the peeps will interact with them more and be able to throw out better stuff. So, yeah, I'm going to unpause it so you can see the stream is still going. I'm still here other than the face cam. JSTOR asking, hey, Adam. Will peeps walk in groups in the future? Something that they wanted to work on. Oh, there goes some trash. Look at that, because I have no trash cans. They're just throwing stuff on the ground. And I have it turned up. So let's go over at normal speed. Thank you very much. Gestalt asking, what happens with the grid when piece by piece is released? Will it still be the same? Will there be a snap function? And will it remember the height? That's a very good question. I'm not entirely sure about that, but I don't foresee any huge changes with the actual grid itself. And I hope it would stay the same because you're already used to how it works now. So snapping and height, remembering all the heights and settings and stuff like that would definitely be a huge one. I saw that one. Major B asking about the day-night cycles. Yes, those are noted as well. Those need to be balanced. Those have not yet been balanced. But do know that they have been noted. Soupy Kitten asking, will there be an undo and redo feature in the future? As of right now, it has been noted, but I have not heard any word on whether or not that's going to be implemented. I know it would be nice for a lot of people. You thinking about thoughts? Nope. Angry. You hungry? We'll go eat something. I don't know. You're very angry. Maybe you're hangry. Let's scroll up on some more chat here. The undo redo, the no confirmation on that yet, although a lot of people have been asking for it. JSTOR second to double up on the peeps walking in groups. I think we got those. Western scenery, vending machine, grid with the piece by piece. I saw those. So come all the way down to the bottom. We're pushing towards the end here. Nice. Nookreed facial expression expansion pack coming soon. Please. If you guys have the time, make some UGC. Challenge accepted. And I am going to get a zoom feature for the face cam so that I can get some extreme close-ups that you guys can use for your memes. I love those. They make me laugh so hard. Families, Roy the Dragon, that's kind of similar to the other question Gestalt was asking about grouping, mentioned by quite a few different people. So UGC, Nookreat memes, and create whatever you want. I think that just upped the game. And those are pretty much for Yeah, thank you for the update in the stream. You're most welcome. I see the mod nuking some more posts. Yeah. DJ. Good, good, good. Yep, that's what happens. That's fine. Water rides are a must. Anavir, yes. People have mentioned water rides. They're not coming yet, but they have been noted. You are not Wayne at Extreme Close-Up thing. I know. Good. You caught Roy the Dragon. Shout out to Roy the Dragon in chat. He's the only one that caught that reference. Oh, Turdell, you decided to come and hang out. Welcome to the chat. I see you. That balloon, though, yes. When will the update be released? We're hoping this week. Again, nothing is in stone yet because they're still putting it through the ringers of QA right now. So QA, for those that aren't well aware of game industry terminology, quality assurance is what QA stands for. I actually had that question a couple of streams back. So Dave asking me specifically, Adam, are you proud of the game? What you like about it and what you don't like about it? Well, yes, I'm very proud of the game. I've played this all the series in the franchise. The thing that I love the most about it is the continual updates, the dev team working and showing, being able to get this build and show it to you guys. That's one of my most favorite parts of the whole process in general. To share everything that's coming with you guys, it's like, hey, this is what's coming, and then you guys see it, and then we can cycle back and say, okay, well, what's the feedback? What are you guys going to talk about? What's going to be the most pressing thing? What's going to be the best thing? The thing I dislike least, the lack of streams. I would like to stream more, to be honest with you. And I think I'm trying to plan to do some more sandbox and chill stuff. Good chance on this coming Thursday, that's what it will be. The other thing that I'm actually a little disappointed about as well is lack of contests, which falls directly here. And on that note, we are working on something very special that I'm not going to announce. I'm going to build the hype right here, right now. Towards the end of the week, we are working on a contest coming to you guys that's going to be, I don't even know, fantabulous. I just made up a word. That was great. That was lovely. Pound fantabulous. We want to get more people involved. We want to do giveaways. We want to give away stuff. Everything from shirts to posters to game codes and all that good stuff as well. It's just a matter to get you guys involved, to see the creativity, kind of like a little bit better than a featured user park or coaster or whatever the case, a little more challenging, if you will. So stay tuned for those updates because those are coming really soon. Towards the end of the week, we're in the final stages of wrapping up the details of that, and hopefully, yeah, I roll because why no RCTW shirt today? No, wear my fleece. They actually cranked up the AC in the stream room, so it's a little chilly. So I'm wearing my lucky orange streaming fleece, as you are all aware. Yes, Wingard. I can't even pronounce that whole thing. I will sandbox and chill. Yeah, stay tuned for those. Those are coming. And one of the things I want to mention, again, reiterate before we close out the stream here, because it's getting the dankest memes. You ready? The real Chris Sawyer. Optimize. How about we do one of these? You get a little down on the nose, and I give you optimize. So if you didn't grab them there, the streams are going to be archived, as they always are, albeit a little bit late sometimes. I actually just put up the latest Sandbox and Chill over on our YouTube page. And that reminds me, don't forget about us on Facebook, on Twitter, on our forums over at rollercoastertycoon.com. We're on Steam, the discussion threads over there as well. Here on Twitch, if you haven't followed us, we had a whole bunch of follows today, which I really appreciate all the follows. I love how you guys come and hang out here all the time, get the updates, even with Sandbox and Chill. I love it. So, again, if I missed your question in the stream, I do apologize. Shoot it to me in a message. Put it over on the improvement tracker or the bug tracker if it is a bug. And dev team is going to look at it, and I'll get out to you. Again, I'm only one guy, so if I get overloaded with an influx of messages, I really do appreciate your patience. Other than that, we got about 2 minutes left. I want to do one quick scroll through the chat, make sure any other updates or questions, excuse me, updates. You got updates on the brain. Any other questions that I have? Nope, I got those. I get the real Chris Sawyer, eye contact with the camera, I got that one for you. I got them, don't worry, baby. What is it? I'm hopeful. Mr. Bob, you just showed up. We're ending the stream, but it's okay. We're going to archive it. So anything you missed, Dave Inc., no problem. Love it. All the questions, I think that's it. We're closing on a 4 o'clock. Other notifications over here. I think I got all those as well. Again, I really appreciate everybody for hanging out. Follow us over on social media. I'm not going to repeat all of them again, drowning those out. And Thursday, we're looking at the next stream. So hopefully you guys can jump in and stay tuned. Appreciate you guys hanging. I'll see you next time.